I became involved with missions unexpectedly. Everything started with a conversation with one of our pastors, Pat Roberts. He asked me about the country where I come from, Ecuador. I was telling him how it's such a beautiful country and at the same time how it saddens me to see the poverty. He asked me one question. He said, "Why don't you find a place in Ecuador that works with kids? And maybe, then maybe we can do something." I remember thinking a few things that came to my mind in a matter of seconds. I remember thinking, "You're asking me why? Maybe because my family's needs have not been met yet." I thought that missions was only for people that can quote the Bible by heart. But the more I thought of it, the more I became convinced that I had no excuse. That's when I started looking immediately for a place. And I remember making a list of criteria after praying with my sister at my kitchen table. The main thing was that it needed to be Christ-centered. The second thing was that it needed to work with underprivileged kids. And the last one was that it needed to be open to work, to do more than just feed them and clothe them. About a year later, I came across It's About Kids. It's a ministry founded by Ron and Sharon Stiff. What impressed me the most about this precious American couple is that they really took the patience and the time to understand them and really study the environment that they were coming from, their idiosyncrasies, and decided to love them up and build them up from there. As many of you know, last July we took a trip there and to deliver over 300 pounds of school supplies, t-shirts, and Bibles. One night, as we were sitting there in their living room, their 9-year-old son, Tony, was playing the keyboard for us. Then David, one of the older guys, decided to join in. They started singing worship songs in Spanish, and then the other kids decided to join in as well. Their house was filled with worship. That same night, Tony recounted the story of a time when he was hacked by a machete with this drunk old man in his native little town in the jungle of Ecuador. His head was sliced open. He was 3 years old. I asked him if he remembered it, and he said, yes, vividly. He even had the scar to prove it. That same Tony was there that night, praising God, as so many of us were, regardless of our story. I was moved beyond words. That night at the Stiff's living room, I remember seeing clearly a picture of what God did with me. He took me in, he made me part of his family, he showed me the unconditional love of our Heavenly Father. So I'm glad that I listened to Pastor Pat Roberts' challenge. I'm glad that I didn't listen to my fears and limitations. I'm glad that I was willing to obey, because he did the rest. With this challenge, I found out that the best place to be is in the middle of his will.